Hey, and welcome to this week's Tarot Insights. Today, we're going to be talking about the week of October 28th, which is my nephew's birthday, Thomas's birthday, through October 28th through November 3rd. Okay, let's see who we've got coming on. All right, we have Sally, Justine, Shayna, Jesse. Hey. All righty, and we'll see who else comes on. Up, we have Raven. Let's see, Danielle joined us, Jean joined us, Gail joined us. Boy, we've got a lot on today. All right. Well, this is the scoop. I just picked the winner for last week. It's Marty Muncy. So, Marty, I will connect with you. You won the meditation CD. Up, Giles came on, Ashley came on. All right. Well, good evening to you too, Pam. Up, and Sophie joined us. Jesse's got a big day tomorrow, so let's hope we get some good mojo for her. All right. Well, what we're going to do is what we always do. We're going to talk about the energy that's coming up over the next week. Hi, Lindsay and Pamela. Glad you could join us. Now, sometimes I miss some of you because a bunch come on at once and it goes by too fast. So if I don't say hi, I'm not ignoring you. It means that a bunch of you came on at the same time. All right. So we're getting lots of love. All right. So let's see what we have. Let's start with Monday, the 28th, which is my nephew Thomas's birthday. Let's see what the energy is for that. What's the energy for Wednesday? Well, this is a card that means that, I actually got two cards that came up. One of the things that I got was the Lovers upside down. And what that means is you may find it's a day to put off making choices, or if you're making choices, making sure that you're seeing him clearly, making sure you're paying attention to your common sense and to your intuition equally. I also got this card, which is the Nine of Wands upside down. And this is the card of not feeling like you're being chased anymore, not feeling like you need to be defensive. And so, I think I said hi to everybody so far. So there's not needing to feel defensive and not feeling the need to be overly watchful. But combined with the Lovers card, it's really talking about making sure that you're seeing clearly and making sure that you are using a combination of your intuition and your common sense. So let's see what we have for Tuesday. Tuesday, we have the Emperor upside down. The Emperor upside down is a card that is really about thinking twice before you talk, making sure you're seeing clearly. So you're seeing a theme here, right? Making sure you're thinking clearly. The Emperor upside down can mean time to just kind of hang out and wait. So be aware that Tuesday may be a day that we need to, again, it's not a marching forward day. It's more of a thinking day. Let's see about Wednesday. What's the energy for Wednesday? Wednesday, we have the Ace of Cups. Wednesday, you may find, oh, we had a couple more people come in. Cindy, Rhonda, Amanda, Jessica. We got it. Good to see you. Three upside down cards already. Well, this is right side up. So yeah, the other was, yes, you're right, Sophie. The other ones were upside down. But for Wednesday, we're right side up, and we have the Ace of Cups. The Ace of Cups is love, fertility, creativity. It's emotional, but it's your emotions are right side up, right? You're not in the cup, so to speak. Hi, Marta. Glad you could join us. So on by the time we get to Wednesday, I think what you're going to find is that we're feeling better emotionally, and we have better emotional coping skills. Up, hi, Aisha. Good for you to join us. All right. So let's see about Thursday. Thursday, we have the King of Pentacles. This deck that I'm using, I lent my regular deck to a student. I'm doing a tarot, three-week tarot class. And so I lent my deck, and so this is the other one I had on my desk. And these cards are, they show the back of the card. It shows the opposite of what you would normally see. And so this is the King of Pentacles. The King of Pentacles is grounded, responsible, balanced. And so Thursday, I think what you're going to find is that we're in a better space. Monday and Tuesday take a little bit of checking in with yourself, right? But by the time we get into Wednesday and Thursday, we're more grounded, we're feeling more loved, we're feeling things a lot better. Yeah, we'll all be looking forward to it. Now, you know, Cindy, when Cindy says, I'll be looking forward to Wednesday then, right? Just because we get reversed cards doesn't mean they're bad. When we get some reverse cards you'd rather have, like the devil can be your constipated, so having it reversed means everything flows freely, you know, so it can mean you're tied up or having financial burdens. So sometimes we want those cards reversed. And even the lovers, sometimes we have to look hard and fast at our choices and our discernment. And so sometimes we need to stop and think and make sure that we're using both our higher judgment and our common sense. And so it's not always bad. Hi, Melissa, glad you could join us. It's not always bad when the cards are reversed, but it does make us pause and say, let me look at this. Let me rethink this. Let me make sure I'm seeing things clearly. So that's Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Let's get to Friday. What's the energy for Friday? Friday, we have an upside down card. We have the Knight of Cups upside down. So Friday, you may find that people's feelings are hurt easily, that they're a little bit more emotional, that they're not feeling the love, you know. So Friday, again, we have a reverse card. Doesn't mean it's terrible. No, but it may mean that Friday is a day where you have to choose, am I giving my love freely? Am I giving my love without boundaries? Or is it good to establish some boundaries? Have I been, it may sound contradictory, but have I been over-loving, right? Am I smothering someone? And so there are times when we may choose that it's good to call back and to take a time to really review. And that's Friday. Let's see what Saturday holds. Saturday, we have the card of focus. When it's right side up, and this is one of the times I like a card upside down as well. This card right side up means an awful lot of options. And sometimes it's like, you know, it just don't give me so many options. Just give me a few and let me choose. And so Saturday, we have a day of focusing on what's really important to us, seeing clearly what was hidden before. Because if you notice right here, the card is covered. So when it's reversed, that means all of the things that were covered in the past are revealed. And so Saturday, I think that we're going to be more focused. We're going to see things a little bit more clearly. Oh, hi, Angela. Oh, glad you could join us from California. All righty. Hope everything's safe over there. Let's look at Sunday. What's the energy for Sunday? Sunday, we have judgment upside down. So yes, we've had a predominantly upside down week here. So this is a week, well, let me finish Sunday first and then I'll summarize. But this is a week where we really want to make sure, especially on Sunday, that we're careful with our judgments, right? Now, why could we like it reversed? And one of the things may be, we may be being too judgmental. Right? So let's back away from the judgments. It could be that we feel so pressured to make a decision that we're making a poor decision. Let's back off away the decision making. Now, it could be not a great day. It could be, gosh, I can't make any decisions. I can't make any choices. I'm just not seeing clearly. So let's just review. We have cards. We have a week where there's seven cards and five out of seven are reversed. So what does that mean? When we look at the generality of it, then what I would say, oh, hi Leah, glad you could join us. What I would say in general about the week is it's a week where we stop, review, make sure we're clear on how we want to proceed. It's not saying don't proceed, but it's saying stop and make sure that that's the direction you want to go. Monday, we had the lovers upside down and the eight of wands. We had two cards there. And that is saying on Monday, we want to make sure that we're making choices because it is our decision. Is it what we really want to do? Is it combining both our intuition and our common sense? On Tuesday, we have the Emperor upside down, which is a card of not making things happen, being patient, having to allow things to bubble up to the surface before we can make things happen. On Wednesday, oh, hi, Edie, good to see you. On Wednesday, we have the Love card. We're feeling The love card is a great time for social. It's also a great time to really spend some time with your emotions and allow them to flow. Thursday, we have the King of Pentacles, and we're going to feel more grounded. It's a great day to deal with money situations. It's a great day to get things done that you've maybe been putting off. Friday is a day where we're easily hurt. Our feelings are hurt. So let's be kind, extra kind on Friday. Saturday, we see things clearly. We're focused and we're not distracted. And on Sunday, we're going to hold off making big choices or judgments. So that's the overall feel for the week. Let's see what the message is. So just bear with me while I ask what the message is for the week. Ah, that's interesting. So, oh, hi, Vicki. Thanks for joining us. So what did I see? I heard canola oil, right? Canola oil. And I don't know, at first canola oil was the next big thing. And then you hear canola oil is terrible for you. It's like bacon. You know, bacon's good for you, bacon's bad for you. This is good for you, this is bad for you. And so this is a week to really look at making sure that you're not making your choices and decisions with limited information or old information. And also that truth changes. Tatum's doing good. I'll talk about that in a second. Truth changes. And what may be deemed as healthy and good is now may not be later. And so we need to adapt. And we also need to use our own discernment. How does it feel to me, along with our common sense and the information that we have out there to make our choices? So Jean asked how Tatum's doing. Tatum's my bird, and Tatum has a bacterial infection, and so he's having a little bit of a hard time, but he's not happy with us right now because we had to take out all his toys. And if you know anything about birds, they get very connected to routine, and they like things to stay the same, and so Tatum's having a little hard time, but he's going to be okay. All right. Well, thank you very much. Oh, Aaron joined us as well. Thank you very much for joining me, and we will see you next week. Hope to see you back here at the same time. All right. Blessings. Bye-bye.